In this video, I'm answering 5 questions on sustained attention. What is sustained attention? What are examples of sustained attention? How long is sustained attention? What are problems and disorders related to poor sustained attention? And how can we test sustained attention? Let's get to it. 1. What is sustained attention? Sustained attention is the ability to focus on an activity or stimulus over a long period of time. It's what makes it possible to concentrate on an activity for as long as it takes to finish it, even if there are other distracting stimuli present. Sustained attention is usually divided into vigilance, which is detecting the appearance of a stimulus, and concentration, which is focusing on the stimulus or activity. This cognitive skill helps us carry out tasks and activities in our daily lives, especially those which take a long time to complete. 2. What are examples of sustained attention? Firstly, students at school have to pay attention when they are in class and when they are studying at home. Poor sustained attention could result in poor academic performance. Secondly, driving for any amount of time requires sustained attention, as you have to constantly keep your eye on the road and watch for potential accidents. Fatigue or distractions on the road could have fatal consequences, which is one of the reasons why this skill is important for driving. Finally, many of the tasks which we come across in our daily lives require some level of sustained attention, whether it be watching a movie, cooking food, or taking a shower. In fact, you're using your sustained attention right now as you're watching this video. 3. How long is sustained attention? Firstly, common estimates of the attention span of healthy teenagers and adults range from 10 to 20 minutes. However, there is no empirical evidence for this estimate. People can repeatedly choose to refocus on the same thing, which is why people can pay attention to things which last for more than 20 minutes, such as lengthy movies. Secondly, an account cited that the average attention span in children is 7 minutes for 2-year-olds, 9 minutes for 3-year-olds, 12 minutes for 4-year-olds, and 14 minutes for 5-year-olds. Thirdly, people are generally capable of a longer attention span when they are doing something which they find enjoyable or intrinsically motivating, such as playing video games. A person's attention also increases if the person is able to perform the task fluently, compared to a person who has difficulty performing the task, or to the same person when she or he is just learning the task. So when you're doing something fun or motivating or something you're good at, your sustained attention for that task is usually strong. But when you're doing something you find difficult or something you're not good at yet, your sustained attention for that task is usually weak. Finally, according to a scientific study, collected evidence found that attention span peaks in humans' early 40s, then gradually declines in old age. 4. What are problems and disorders related to poor sustained attention? Attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or attention deficit disorder, may be the most well-known disorder whose main difficulty is sustained attention. Attentional disorders are also present in dyslexia, schizophrenia, Alzheimer's disease, or dementias in general. Finally, it's quite common to see poor sustained attention in people who have suffered brain damage, whether from a stroke or from chronic traumatic encephalopathy.
Encephalopathy. It's a difficult word. I know. It means damage or disease which affects your brain. It happens when there's been a change in the way your brain works or a change in your body which affects your brain. When this happens, when you have chronic traumatic encephalopathy, it negatively affects your sustained attention.
5. How can we test sustained attention?
We can measure sustained attention by taking the sustained attention test, a measure of attentional disturbance. This test is a vigilance test designed to assess the ability of individuals with schizophrenia to sustain attention to visual stimuli.
The task requires the subject to attend to two vertically adjacent squares on a computer monitor. Each square changes color at random intervals. The subject's task is to respond when the two adjacent squares become the same color. The resulting data provide a straightforward assessment of sustained attention and are not confounded by processes such as perceptual organization, working memory, or context processing, which are required by many other vigilance tasks.
This information came from these websites. You'll find these links below this video. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Subscribe to my channel and watch this series from the start. Next Friday, I'll be interviewing Londis Lane, a lawyer and author from Michigan, on the importance of meaningful relationships. Be sure to watch that interview. Till then, I only want to say three things. Thank you for watching, have a great day, and bye for now.